So first we need to open the software, go to the program, and in program as usual open NV 4.7, and under different options you will have to select the NV. The moment you will select the NV, this window will appear with the different options, and first you will have to open the file. So we will open any file which has been created. Last time we had done the practical on unsupervised classification, but this time we will do practical on supervised classification. Last time you had also learned how to do the layer stacking, and the similar product you can see in this directory. You can see this LC08, which is basically the Landsat 8 satellite, 145th path and 040 row, then 2017 year, and the month is 6, and the 2nd of the month, 2nd of the June, and B125, that is representing 1 to 5 band. So these bands have been stacked over, and an image has been created with these 5 bands. The moment you will open that file, these 5 bands would be displayed or listed in this available band list. Now you can either display it in the grayscale, or you can display it in the red, green, blue or color. But the condition to display image in the color would be that you will require a set of 3 bands. For display the image in grayscale, you can select any band and that's it. Then you can press the load button, and that way the image would be displayed in the grayscale. So you can select any band, and you can see in every band, because these are representing the different wave regions, so every band will produce the same object or same area with the different patterns. You can see when I will select the different band, the pattern will be changed. You see, the pattern is changing. You see, and the drastic changes would be when you will switch between the visible band. Visible bands are from band number 1 to 4 and near infrared band, which is band number 5. You see, there is a drastic change in appearance when you are switching between the visible band and an IR band. You see, it is just opposite side of the image. It is just like negative of the photograph. You see, those in the bright color in near infrared region, they will be the darker color in the visible region, and vice versa. As I mentioned that you can also display the same region or same image in the color, but with the condition that you will require at least 3 bands, at least 3 bands, and fortunately we are having 5 bands. Band number 1 you can see, band number 2, band number 3, band number 4, band number 5. If you want to see it in the true color composite, or if you want to see as it will appear from the space, so you will have to select the band of the same color. Like R stand for red color, G stand for green, and B stand for blue. So against R you will have to select the red band, and red band is here band number 4. G is green, and band number 3 is the green band. B B is blue and band number 2 is the blue band. Band number 1 is the aerosol band with a very narrow bandwidth. So that is not usually selected for visually displaying the image. Now we had selected bands, these three bands, as per their respective or their native colors. And now if you will display, the region will appear as it will appear from the space, not as it will appear from the ground, but as it will appear from the space. Then you can have certain enhancement, like contrast enhancement. You have done it in the past as well, like this. Now the things are little more clearer. There are multiple schemes of the contrast enhancement, from linear to linear 0 to 255, then linear 2%, Gaussian, equalization, and square root. There are multiple schemes. You can select any scheme in which your objects are appearing clear. Maybe this in this scheme 2% linear, everything in this image is crystal clear. You can see this area is representing the Sidkul region of Rudrapur, and little right hand side, if you will move, then you will find your old university with this semicircular structure. Semicircles, you can see the first circle of the college and the second circle of the hostels. Now, it is to a certain extent clear in the image that what are the different objects. For example, these objects like this. Now, before going into the detail, I would like to tell you, or I would like to explain you, that these are the three windows when you will open any region. The window number 1 is this scroll window, in which the entire image would be displayed. So it is kind of a thumbnail. And then you can see a rectangular red circle inside this image rectangle. So this circle is basically for displaying the part of this image with the full resolution in this window, which is known as the image window. This is image window. And then another square or the rectangular circle you can see in this image, and this rectangular circle is to display the selected region in the zoom window. And zoom window used to offer you the functionality of zoom in and zoom out. You can see at the left bottom there are three buttons: minus button, plus button, and no sign button. So no sign button will produce this red crosshair, while this minus button will basically zoom out, and plus button will zoom in this way. Now, what I was explaining, that most of the objects in this image, those are visible, those can be easily identified. Like this region is belonging to the fallow field. Similarly, these green patches, these are belonging to the vegetation, and because it is the university complex, the vegetation here in this case would be crop. Then if you will move little upward, crossing the railway line, this is the railway line, then you will find this vegetation, and this vegetation is along the river. So green vegetation you can see this patch, and then you can also see the other regions, and these are again planted forest, because this land is belonging to the forest department. These are the planted forest, it is not natural vegetation. Along river or along water body, there would be natural vegetation. These regions which are very bright. These. In zoom window you can concentrate. These regions which are very bright, these are built up land. And built up land will sometime produce the same signature as a fallow land will. The reason being is that when you are building a land, you are using clay and sand, and also in the fallow field you will have plenty of clay and sand. So for that reason, sometime the appearance of the clay land and appearance of the fallow field, that will resemble. If you will go to this Rudrapur region, then you will see this is again the built up land, and the signature is kind of a mixed signature. Why mixed signature? Because when you are seeing a city like Rudrapur, where multiple objects are available at the common place, like there would be roads in the city, there would be houses in the city, some houses are old, some houses are new, there would be some trees, there would be water channels, roads, etc., etc. So what I mean to say is there are multiple objects within a small piece of land, and the signature which you are seeing is the combined signature of these different objects. So for that reason, no, that will produce a very rough kind of signature. This is very rough kind of signature in the built-up land, especially in the habitation. Similarly, you can also see the water bodies. This is water body you can see. You want to see it in the zoom window, so this is water body, and water is supposed to absorb all the incident radiation. That means that the radiation which will fall on the water body, that would be absorbed, and only a minuscule amount of radiation would be reflected. That too only over a few bands, over few regions of electromagnetic spectrum. So for that reason, when the radiation has not been reflected, so camera will not sense any energy, and for that reason the water body will appear as a darker patch, right? So these are the objects as they will appear in the natural colors. You can also make use of other color combinations, like if suppose you are you want to use this near infrared. Near infrared is not having any native color. So what you can do is you can give a color which is close to that region. So it is near infrared, inferior to red, but near. That means it is a region which is close to the red, but wavelength is inferior than that. So that suggests that this band is close to red, so you can give red color to this band number 5, which is near infrared region. So select it, and now you can see band number 5 has been selected here. Then band number 4 is red band, so you can give green color to red and blue color to green band. This width is the green band, and once you have selected this, then load it. And now you can see that most of the region which was appearing earlier as green, now it has turned red. And why it has turned red? Because you have given red color to an IR band, right? And you would be aware that vegetation used to reflect heavily in the near infrared region. So for that reason, because near infrared region has been heavily reflected and you have given red color to near infrared region, for that reason the vegetation in this case is appearing as red. Okay, now many things are clear from this color combination. if anything which is not clear to you, you can just see, you can see the latitude and longitude of that region. For example, if of these pixels in this image window, if this object is not known, what you can do is you just press right hand button and see the cursor location or value. This window will appear, the small window, and whenever you will move your cursor over any object, so it will show you the latitude and longitude. So these latitude and longitudes can be recorded, and by using the GPS you can go to the ground, you can physically go to this place and then see what it is. So that way, you know, those objects which are not easily identifiable, those can be identified by physically visiting those objects. Now, once you have done it, once you have identified all the objects which are available in this image, and this image is covering approximately 185 kilometer region. Once you have identified all the objects, then you will have to train the software. And the training would be that you will have to tell the software that these pixels are belonging to this particular category. And this is possible by creating ROI over those selected objects. ROI is the region of interest. So you can just use this overlay function, and in overlay you can see the region of interest, ROI. When you will press, this small window will appear, right? And then you can see this by default, by default first ROI has been created, but the fields are empty, and these fields would be filled the moment you will select pixel in the image. Let us start selecting the pixel, or let us start identifying the water body first, and then rest other things will follow. But before starting or initiating the selection, one should ensure as to in which window out of these three you want to select the pixels. And this you can ensure by selecting the appropriate radio button in the top of this image. You can see right now, or by default, it will select the image window. Image window is this. If you want to select the pixel in the zoom window, so you will have to select this zoom window option. This. Now you can select pixel in the zoom window. And let us start selecting the water body first. This is the water body, black, and then you can just create ROI. ROI is just kind of a selection of the pixel by digitizing some regions. Now you see, once you have completed this selection of the pixel, press right hand button. Once you will press the right hand button, this dollar inside this digitized boundary will appear, and if you will press again inside this dollar button, then this would be filled. So now your selection is over, and now you can see that you have selected 351 pixels. If you want to select more pixels, you can create another ROI like this. You can create And now you can see the total number of pixels has increased to 511, and two ROI you have created, and in these two ROI you have selected total 511 pixels. So you have selected first ROI. After selecting this pixel, then you will have to tell the software that this is this object just by writing the name of the object. So here the object is water body. After writing, press enter button so that this is recognized water body. Once the selection of water body is over, then go to the new region, and another empty ROI would be created. Now you can select maybe vegetation, and vegetation would be of the different kinds. Like there would be forest region, there would be crop region, fallow region, etc., etc. This we know that just after this Haldi railway station there is a forest region. So we can just focus on this region so that it is appearing in the zoom window, and now we can select few pixel of this. So select, you can see this one ROI has been chosen, another ROI can be created. Like this, so it is dense forest. Then you can also see here certain plots with the green colors, but not true green, it is kind of a cyan color. And these are the plots having the plants, the planted forest, but deciduous plants. So you can also select few regions here, create new region, and few pixels here. Planted deciduous. Now new region. There is another kind of vegetation which is having a different texture, and it seems to be the vegetation, but not so thick as in the case of the dense forest. So we can select few pixel of this as well. Like this. Like this. Again forest, but thin forest, yeah, open forest. Now fallow field we can choose, and the Pantnagar region is the best to select the fallow field. These are the fallow field you can see in the zoom window. Built-up land can also be selected, but built-up land in this case is quite similar. But anyway, we will select built-up land. There are certain other regions which are far off from our place, but these are having particular response, particular, very whitish. These are kinds of, you know, the salty or, yeah, the salt affected soils. These, you can have another group for the these lands. is remaining is agricultural crops. And again, Pantnagar region could be the best region to select the agricultural crops. And here we are able to see some crops. You can increase the zoom level if you want. Whenever you are selecting pixel for a particular category, always try to select only pure pixels. If you will not select pure pixel, then there would be mixing and the result would be erroneous. There is another category here. It seems to be the grassland. Yeah, pinkish. I think we have now selected enough categories and now we can go for classification. Once you have satisfied in terms of selecting these categories, then go to classification and instead of unsupervised, this time you will have to select supervised classification. And in supervised, there are different algorithms which are available. You can select anyone, like parallel pipe, minimum distance, Mahalan abyss, maximum likelihood, spectral angle mapper, this and that. So, maximum likelihood classifier is one which is heavily used, but then the importance of others that cannot be ruled out. So, maybe we can select minimum distance. Once you have selected that, then it will ask you to select the input file. So input file would be this file, the file over which you have created ROIs. Select it. If you want to select a subset of this, you can define here. If you want to select the spectral subset, yes, we can define. The first band is not so useful, so maybe the rest 4 band we can select. Now you can see out of 5 bands we have selected the 4 bands. If you want to concentrate on a specific region, that can be chosen from here, like a spatial subset. And in spatial subset, then there are the different options available, image, and here you can select the regions. And then other options are also available, map. Here you will have to define the coordinates, latitude, longitude. Then the file, if suppose an existing file is there which is having certain dimensions, that can be selected and accordingly the subset of this image would be created. Then ROI, if suppose you want to select your region through ROI, that is also possible. Right now we will select through image, and in the image when you will select, you will find again a rectangular red region which may not be visible from that place, but it is there when you look at the screen. And the size of this can be increased and decreased here by selecting the samples and the lines. Samples are basically the columns. So when you will increase maybe 1000 by 1000, so then the size of that rectangular will increase. So now the big rectangle has been created. And you can place this rectangle at any place, and then only that place would be selected and classified. Because both things you are doing in a single step. You can further increase the size of this to 2000 by 2000 like this, and then you can classify, or maybe even bigger than this, 3000. Once you have selected, say OK, and again say OK, and now here you can see the subset information has been entered here, this, and then say OK, and now it is asking you to select these ROI, whether you want to create all the categories or only the selected category. So again the selection is possible, or you can select all. Then this, you can set maximum standard deviation single value, but don't define anything here. Maximum distance error single value, but don't define anything here. Then it will take by default values. Output rule image, if you want to see, then you can say yes. If you don't want to see, say no. So this, when you will press this, the first, the yes will occur, and if you will again press it, then it will toggle to that. Enter output class file name. So this is important. This is the name of the file which would be created by this process. So this would be the outcome of this classification. Choose and save it at desired location. Maybe PG practical. This data we have chosen, so we will define it. We will save it here. Always remember that the name which you are giving to the product, that should be unique, so that at any time you can recognize it just reading the name of the file. For example, in this case I have selected this name. This is the name of the input file, and then if I am writing here classification or class, so it will tell you that I have used this image which is having 5 bands, and this image is having the classified output. That way, always whenever you are defining the name should be clear. The name should give some sense as to you can recognize what has been done in the file. Say open and then say OK. Now you see it is creating the output. And now you can see this new image has been created, and this is the same image to which you have given name, no? This B1 to 5 and the class, and this is the output band, and it is in the multiple color, though it is the single band, but it has been then given certain color. These are the pseudo colors. So when you will display it in the grayscale even, then it would be represented in colors. Okay. Some pseudo colors have been assigned depending upon their categories, and now these colors which you are seeing here, these are the same colors which you have chosen in the ROI window. Anyway, ROI we had not selected. We have not saved on the hard drive. But you can read here the name of the class in this cursor location. Data 3 is representing the planted deciduous forest. This is the dense forest, the green. Yellow is the open forest. Likewise, you can see the different objects. This is planted deciduous. You can see this is the water body in the perfect shape. this is another water body. So you can see that you have selected only one water body, this, but it has identified all the water bodies which are available in this field. Similarly, you had selected only few pixels in the different categories and it has rightly identified other pixels available in the image. I'm not sure if Pantnagar region has been taken in this subset or not. Probably not. We can just look at the latitude and longitude. So the Pantnagar longitude is somewhere 7930, so that is okay. And latitude is somewhere 29.05. So let us see if it is available. 29 is yes, it is available. 29. Yeah, this is Pantnagar. So Pantnagar has been chosen. You can see here, this is fallow field over the larger region, because when the image was taken, most of fields were fallow. But then it is having mixing with the built up land. This magenta color which you are seeing on the screen, that is basically the built up land. And as I mentioned that the fallow field and the built up land, these two would be consisting the sands as well as the clay together. So for that reason sometimes there will be mixing. If you want to remove this mixing entirely, then you will have to select other bands. Like the swirl bands, those are very important. Those can be selected and then the built up land can be easily identified and it can be easily separated out from the fallow field. So that way, in friction of minutes or friction of hour, you can say, you can create classes, you can identify all the pixels, and once you have done it, then you can also calculate the area under these different objects. And that is quite simpler. Go to classification, go to post classification, and in post classification, go to the class statistics. Class statistics. When you will press the class statistics, it will ask you to provide the input file. In this case, input file would be this classified file. So select this and say okay. Again, it is asking you to provide the input file, so again select the same file and say okay. Then it is asking you to select the classes, basic stat, output to screen, output to a text, output to a statistics file. You can choose anything, say okay. And now you can see it has provided the statistics of this classified output. If you see, under water body you have selected 511 points and the system or the software has selected 75,906 points, and these are merely 0.84% of the total image, and the area which is being covered by all these pixels, that would be equivalent to this much, approximately 6,83,50,400 square meter. Similarly, dense forest, you have selected 537 points. It has selected that many points, which is approximately 10%, 9.957% of the total area. Planted deciduous forest, you have selected 826 points. It has selected 9.97% area. Forest open, you have selected 139 points. It has selected that much point, which is approximately 28.479% area. Fallow field, you have selected 191. It has selected that many points, which are equal to 15.46% area. Built up, likewise, 132 and 3.286%. Salt affected, 240 points, 4.733%. Agriculture, 107 points, 5.769%. Grassland, 103 points and 21.498%. That way, you know, you can, in friction of second, you can generate this crucial information which is required for the different kinds of the planning purpose. If you want, you can also convert this area into some other units like hectare or so, and that is simpler. Go to class summary area unit, and here you can select anything like acre or hectare or something like that. So hectare, if you want to select, immediately it will convert the area into the hectare. So that way, by following only few steps and just consuming little bit of the time, you can very easily and accurately classify the entire regions into the different classes, and eventually you can generate information on the area that is covered by the different categories. So thank you very much.